Victorian era, the term drop-dead gorgeous had a much more literal meaning. Now, as an artist, I have learned that different pigments can be made with some very interesting materials. For example, carmine red is made from scaly insects called cochineal. Now, we all love our clothing. We have different clothing from black hoodies to neon pink skirts. And the wide range of colors has created a way for us to express ourselves. And that's really great. But the idea of crushed up bugs may gross some people out. Even so, during the 19th century, there were two pigments made with arsenic, Paris green and Shields green. All right, so with these items, we use them for many different things. And due to the arsenic, death by arsenic became incredibly famous and kind of viral. And with that, the effects of arsenic were not a pretty sight. So to understand arsenic, we need to understand what it's made of. And in Farah and Bulgaria's novel, Color and Fashion, we learn about the different compositions of these pigments. Both contain copper arsenic, which in health contain arsenic trioxide, also known as white arsenic, a deadly poison. Now, with these poisons, we settled for them not because we didn't know about the effects, it's because green was incredibly hard to make at the time. So many people settled for the yellow green created by Carl Wilhelm Scheele, a Swedish pharmaceutical chemist. Later on, Paris green was invented and was very popular due to the fact that for the amount of pigment could range from blue to a deep emerald green. Now, with that, they were used in many different items, so from wallpaper to insecticides, even candy. We used it in several different things, and you might think that people were ignorant about the health risks, but no. Even the wealthy folk knew that arsenic was bad for you, and it was actually a pretty common poison to use at the time against your enemies. But they still used it just because they wanted to. This still led to terrible conditions in factories. So for the women working in these factories, a lot of them were of a lower status and might have not been educated, so that's why they worked in these, because they just didn't know any better. And from these images, there's an actual can. You can see people were aware because it says literally poison in big red letters. People still used it for wallpaper. And this is actually a good illustration of how people thought that arsenic was good for you. It was kind of an antibacterial kind of thing. So with this, the problems grew and it became a news phenomenon. So many different women lost their lives in these factories, as I said before. Allison Davis, a journalist and novelist, studied the effects that this fabric would have on women's bodies. Now here are a few dresses and what they look like, as well as headdresses. So any part of your body that came in contact with the pigment from your dress would leave sores and blisters all over the body. Even men who did not wear these pigments could still be affected. It is reported that men would get blisters and sores in their nether regions due to touching their wives' dresses and then using the restroom. Not very comfortable, as I would presume. An even shocking event was a 19-year-old girl died horribly due to unintentional poisoning from the arsenic. She was found dusting pigment, similar to these headdresses, on fake leaves. And she puked green bile, she had blisters and sores all over her body, her skin was green, the whites of her eyes were green, and her vision was green as well. So you might be asking, how much arsenic did she actually have in contact with, and what are the symptoms? Here's the gross photo I talked about. So, she had enough arsenic in her body to kill 20 men. And this was due to the fact that she ingested a lot of the pigment due to it being floating in the air, having contact with it just from brushing the pigments onto the leaves, and in general just being around it. For the women who were wearing the dresses, the symptoms were a little bit more subtle. Of course, blisters and sores were a telling sign. However, as said in our review for arsenic poisoning and its effect on the human health, many people would have things like achy muscles, numbness in toes and fingers, and it would continue further with psychosis, seizures, organ failure, and then finally death. So, it is even rumored that Napoleon Bonaparte's death was caused from the wallpaper in his home, which was painted with Scheele's green. So, for us, it might be a ridiculous idea that people paint with arsenic. However, during the time, it was an incredibly trendy color. And due to that, many journalists and doctors called out how bad these pigments were, and luckily, those women did not die in vain. Now we know not to mess with arsenic and pigments, even though we still use arsenic green to color blue in fireworks. So, just to recap, even if you're grossed out by red dye being made of crushed up bugs, remember that it could be a lot worse. And also remember, beauty can have a price, your life.